Dear students, your activity 3 of unit 4 is about make a list of undesirable behavior in the classroom and school. Compare your list with that of your friends. Means whatever undesirable behavior you observe in the classroom or school campus, that can be listed in this chart. What it can be? Don't throw any chalk pieces towards your friends. Then wait for your turn. If teacher is explaining, listen carefully. Do not talk with your seating mate or with someone in the class. You should have to be very much careful while teacher is talking to you. Then the second thing, you have to follow the orders whatever are instructed by the teachers. Then you can make the chart of these things and display it in the class. Means opposite to this, the undesirable behavior you have to write down. So it may give an idea to the other students that we should not behave in such ways because it is called as undesirable behavior. That can be the purpose of doing such activity. Now coming towards activity 4. Is your main poem of the unit 4, that is about at the theater in bracket to the lady behind me. Here the narrator is writing us the poem and he is talking to us about what the lady behind him is sitting doing while watching the theater, means drama. We can understand because you can see that the people, those who are the actors, are there on the stage. They are doing some actions and audience are sitting in front of them. Here the narrator starts with very polite talks for the lady. Dear madam, you have been seeing this play. I never saw it till today. Means ma'am, you may have seen this play, but maine aaj tak ye play nahi dekha hai. Many a times when we go for a movie or a drama, at that time the person may have seen it beforehand or pehle hi ek bar dekh liya hota hai. At that time they continuously keep on talking the next plot or the next dialogues, so that really becomes annoying, and that is everything explained over here. I never saw it till today. You know the details of the plot, but let me tell you, I do not. Here very humbly the narrator is saying that, ma'am, I do not know the plot, means whatever is next happening, I don't know that. So please don't tell it beforehand. The author seeks to keep from me, means author of the drama or the play, whatever is going on, wants to keep it secret from me at this stage, because then only I can enjoy the murderer's identity at the end. And you are not a friend of his if you keep shouting, who is it? Means the lady is having the habit of, we can clearly understand that the lady is continuously talking about the further incidents of the drama, and she is even talking about the main culprit of the drama, and that is disturbing a lot to the author. Students, I know that I am explaining this to you in English, but see the your language, this one is English, and that way, if I am explaining you in simple way, you should have to focus on it more identically, so you can write down it in detail when question answers will be asked based on the poem or based on any topic. That is my purpose of making it in English. Though I know you can get Hindi translation of it, but better way is to try to understand it in simplified English, and that is my main motto over here. Hope you understand and like it. Let me know with your views. And you are not a friend of his if you keep shouting, who is it? You are not a friend even of the narrator, of the playwright, means author, means the playwright of that drama. Then why you are shouting in between, who is the murderer? The action in there. Here, the narrator is further telling to the lady that the actors are in their funny way, have several funny things to say. Means they are talking in their funny way. They want to amuse us and they are talking several funny things to say. But they do not amuse me more if you have said them just before. Means if they have any funny comic scenes that are also you are revealing. So that is not making any sense to me. Though you are happy maybe. आपको अगर खुशी भी हो रही है वो पहले बताने में, but मुझे उसमें मजा नहीं आ रहा है, जबकि वो ज्यादा मुझे मनोरंजक लगने चाहिए तो भी वो मुझे लग नहीं रहे. The merit of the drama lies, I understand, in some surprise. Means according to narrator, the narrator is saying that the merit means the quality or the enjoyment of the drama is only in understanding it with some surprises. But the surprise now must be small since you have just foretold all. Why the surprises has become small? Because you have started telling it everything. Foretold all. Just foretold means beforehand here. This is one similar word for foretold. Means you are telling everything before that narrator or before that drama. So that is why it is becoming difficult for me and I am losing the surprise of it. The lady you have brought with you is, I infer, a half-wit too. Means, I infer here means he want to excuse in a different way that you have brought even a half-wit also. Means the lady, someone who is not mindful but can understand the piece without assistance from your niece. Means the lady has came up with her niece also and she is also talking in between. That is also again disturbing the narrator. So he wants to say that I can understand the drama or the piece of content, the drama. So without your assistance, I am going to understand it. So do not disturb me. Indirectly, he is talking it to the lady. In short, foul woman, it would suit me just as well if you were me. Mute. In short, foul woman, it would suit me just as well if you were mute. Means whatever you are entertaining, whatever jokes you are disclosing before, that won't suit me right now. But if you will be mute, means will keep quiet. Foul woman in a negative way, he is calling to the woman. Actually, the meaning of the foul is bad or dirty. But here, we can say that it's a negative adjective used for the lady to convey the message that you have to keep quiet now. In fact, to make my meaning plain, I trust you will not speak again. Means if I will say it softly or in a plain way, I trust that you will not talk again. Why? Because I have given you many more chances to be quiet. And may I add one human touch? Don't breathe upon my neck so much. Again, he wants to say, when the back person, while you are sitting on your chairs, the rows are there, one behind one, you could feel the breathing sense of the person who is sitting at the back. That is also annoying here to our narrator. And this way, really, students, this is a very nice poem about how to behave.